My name is Anand, and I'd like to share a few thoughts and perspective with you on resilience in the supply chain. Disruptions have a tendency to test the resilience of supply chains. Currently, we continue to see epidemics like the coronavirus drastically affect operations of many businesses, regardless of industry or vertical. Manufacturers, logistics providers, and distributors find themselves needing to make very quick, reactive changes, but unfortunately, not all are equipped to do so. In fact, recent research conducted by Ames has found that the majority of companies require weeks, if not months, to answer network-related questions. Clearly, in a situation where agility is essential, risks are not being addressed within an acceptable time. So, what does it really take to go from months to weeks to hours and to truly become resilient? I think a balance lies between a reactive and a proactive approach towards resilience. It's required with the help of advanced analytics and prescriptive tools that are at the forefront of providing this shift in paradigm. Here at Ames, we have seen both in action. On one hand, companies can evaluate the effect that closing certain warehouses or plants can have on their supply chain. By dynamically adjusting capacities and utilization within the apps, they were able to optimally reallocate volumes and develop new production and distribution plan within hours. On the other hand, proactively designing supply chain requires modeling different uncertainties and events well before they happen, like hurricanes or politically induced tariffs. In one such analysis, we found demand simulations where demand increased per year pinpoint exactly where and when the network will essentially break and also provide many different strategic inputs. If this topic is of interest to you, there are many more resources available. Please feel free to go and check them out. Thank you.